Well, hey, everyone out there. This is Janice Wright at the Garrison Public Affairs Office. And today we are talking with the representatives from our lawn and garden department under Calvary Family Housing and about all the wonderful ways they helped keep the great place great. All that and more on this episode of the Great Big Podcast. Well, welcome back, everyone. We're sitting here with representatives from Calvary Family Housing, and we're going to talk about a special organization we have here at Fort Cavazos, the Lawn and Garden Department. So won't you guys introduce yourselves to our listeners?
Hey, good morning, Janice. My name is Chris Albus. I am the project director for Calvary Family Housing in Lend-Lease.
Hello, Janice. My name is Brian Ingram. I am the coordinator of Lawn and Garden, Calvary Housing.
Okay. So I have been fortunate enough to work with both of you a lot, and I've seen so many great things that Calvary Family Housing does, especially with lawn and garden. So tell us a little bit about what lawn and garden is and what kind of services it provides for the great place.
Sure. Lawn and garden is a great amenity. We just talked about, you know, we're one of the few across the DOD that actually have a lawn and garden as part of our project. And it's, you know, it's a place for residents to come and get a variety of things to help improve their not only their lawn, but also the inside of their home as well.
Right. So you guys basically make it easier for them to tackle small tasks on their own instead of having to, you know, get someone else to do it or hire someone else to do it.
Absolutely.
So I know you have plenty of, you know, things that soldiers and family members can rent, such as lawnmowers, or not rent, but sign out, lawnmowers, weed eaters, things like that. But you also have a variety of small items that soldiers and families can use to kind of keep up with the upkeep of their house and not have to worry about somebody else replacing it, like filters and, you know, things like that.
Yes, they have like replacement blinds, door stoppers, things that usually just break on its
right.
own.
Right.
The kids break them. But they have a lot of stuff like that. Sinks, bath stoppers, things that wear out really
right.
quick.
So what's the process in coming to pick up those items? Is there a limit?
It's a limit, but it's free.
Okay.
For them.
Okay.
It's free for them. And that's a good incentive. You know, a lot of people like that they don't have to buy a lawnmower because they may not be there,
mm-hmm.
but, you know, a little tour.
Right. So either the soldier or the family member can come in, present their ID, and have access to all of the supplies you guys have?
Yes.
Okay. And what's the process for signing out a lawnmower or a weed eater?
The process is all you need is your ID.
Okay.
And I have it on my computer to compare it. Mm-hmm. And that's all you need to get, you know, your equipment or any other self-help items.
Right. Okay.
That's all you need is your ID. It's simple.
Okay. And this is specifically for Fort Cavazos residents.
Yeah, for home pole housing.
Okay. So, Chris, tell me a little bit about why the lawn garden and all the things they do is important to help keep, you know, quality of life or maintain that at the Great Place.
Absolutely, Janice. So, well, I'll tell you, the Lawn and Garden is an awesome organization. Residents come by, they get their air filters, make sure that their HVAC system is running efficiently and healthy throughout the entire year. They come over, and we've got two, we just issued our first free giveaway of grass seed.
Yes.
And sod. Grass seed.
Mulch. Yes.
Topsoil.
Yes. Yes.
Which is for area beautification around the house.
Right.
And we're very, very happy about that because we do have a Yard of the Month program.
Yes.
Every month we're out there in all 12 communities and we're awarding a particular resident with a gift card and a sign they can proudly display in their front lawn for maintaining their house. But there's lots of other small items like Brian was just talking about, mm-hmm. that a resident, instead of calling a work order in, the resident can come in and do it himself.
Right.
That's part of our self-help portion of Lawn and Garden. But I'll tell you, just coming by, and talking to the guys that are in Lana Garden, you learn a lot of things about, you know, the Army, Cavalry Family Housing, but just life in general as well.
Mm-hmm. So you guys are like the Home Depot for Fort Cavazos.
Absolutely.
Well, I was out there. I had the pleasure of coming out and interviewing a couple of military soldiers and family members who benefited from that program. And, you know, all in all, it's great because you guys are offsetting the financial cost. Of course, we know that everything is inflated right now, so every little bit helps. So the fact that you guys are giving that away for free, that's awesome.
Absolutely. And we encourage more people to come in. We don't think that every resident, you know, is using this service,
right,
and not taking advantage of it. You're exactly right. Is a shame because it is a cost savings to our
Absolutely.
Residents, and it's a time saver too. Instead of you know, waiting for the service order technician to come out, residents will come by and just fix it themselves. And we're here to support that.
Absolutely. You know, a lot of military families, you know, they have to move, and sometimes, you know, moving with things like lawnmowers is not feasible. So instead of, you know, having to purchase that, it's great that they can just come and sign it out. So what are the stipulations, and how long can they keep a lawnmower or a weed eater or a leaf blower?
Well, if you get it before 12 o'clock at noon, you get 5 hours.
Okay.
And anything after 12 o'clock, you can bring it back 9 o'clock to 10 o'clock the next day.
Okay.
And it's open Monday through Fridays, and Saturdays it's open 8 to 12. But during the week, it's open 8 to 5.
Okay. So for me, I'm slow. It would take me a while. Like, I love to mow my own lawn, but it takes me a while because I'm kind of like a perfectionist and I want the lines to be beautiful and I want it to be even, but yeah. So we've talked about all the resources and things that lawn and garden provides. Why do you think that's important here at the Great Place?
Well, again, I mean, it's a cost savings, another benefit of living on post, to have access to all this stuff. It helps to build pride in our communities.
Absolutely.
It allows not only Cavalry Family Housing, the Army, but it helps the residents to be part of this team of teams in making a house a home.
Absolutely.
And giving a sense of community to our residents that live on post. And I will be honest, when I go out and I present these yards of the month, I'm very proud of the fact that these residents are taking it to heart, and they want to make it a home. They want to make a better community, and they're taking care of their home and their yard as well.
Absolutely. And with all the you know, new construction and the building of the new homes, the maintenance and the upkeep are, you know, important to start off that way to, you know, maintain the homes and keep them nice for as long as possible. Tell us a little bit about, you know, all of the new construction and the new happenings with the housing.
Absolutely. Heritage Heights, which is our new community, is going along very, very quickly. In fact, we're just about a year from having done the ribbon cutting on our first home over there.
Mm-hmm.
And those homes are for junior enlisted, E1 through E6. We cut that ribbon back in June of last year. So thus far, we've built 82 homes that are over there. And they're all occupied by our junior enlisted families. And we're getting ready to move the fence again, because it is, you know, there's a fence that separates off post from on post. And when we move that fence, we'll bring another 14 homes online. So just about every month, we're bringing more and more homes online for junior enlisted families. And I'll be honest, the response has been fantastic. They enjoy the neighborhood. They enjoy the home. And it's very encouraging to see, you know, new families moving into a brand new home here in Fort Cavazos.
So starting out, you guys, you know, give them, you know, beautiful landscape to build upon, and then lawn and garden helps them to maintain it, right?
Absolutely. When we brief them when they move in, we just, you know, put a bunch of sod down for their for their grass, make sure that they're you know, watering the grass, make sure it catches, but also the importance of coming over and getting your air filter.
Absolutely.
And some of these smaller items that we've got in the self-help section of lawn and garden, where they can maintain their own home. And of course, they're always encouraged to call the maintenance work order hotline if they need, you know, bigger maintenance to be done in the house.
Right. So with all the things that are happening, the new construction and all the resources and events that Calvary Family Housing offers, it's clear that it's important to maintain a great quality of life here. So how do you guys think you contribute to that?
Listen, we think this is a very important aspect of what we do. We want to make their stay here as productive and as purposeful and enjoyable as we possibly can. Mm-hmm. Because we realize that this may be a soldier and his family's first assignment here on Fort Cavazos. And if they have a positive first assignment on Fort Cavazos, then they may decide to reenlist in the Army. Mm-hmm. So we take that very, very seriously, and making sure that we're also interacting with them in a very positive manner, treating them with the respect that they require. And I think we do a pretty good job of that, too, as we see in some of the feedback questions that we get and responses we get. The quality of interaction, professionalism that our technicians, like what Brian here, have with our residents has been received very well by our residents.
So basically you're planting the seed, pun intended, for an enjoyable stay here at Fort Cavazos.
Absolutely, which may in fact in turn turn into, like I said, the soldier deciding to stay in the Army and continue his service with the Army.
Absolutely.
And we see a lot of that feedback in, you know, such things that that we're doing right now, including these surveys. Mm-hmm. The Army just released on March 4th their housing tenant satisfaction survey, which is out there now until the 18th of April. And we're getting a lot of feedback on, you know, how residents see our, not only how they see us, individually, you know, our technicians and our community management people, our leasing agents, but also how they see, you know, how they evaluate, you know, services such as the lawn and garden, self-help and equipment loan and stuff like that.
So this feedback kind of helps you guys to assess what's needed and how to move forward.
Yeah, correct. Right. So again, this Army Tenant Housing Satisfaction Survey, which is out there from the 4th of March until the 19th of April, very, very important to get that feedback, because we get that feedback, both Calvary Family Housing and the Army. And from that, we build action plans. And we actually do use those action plans to make improvements inside the community based on feedback that we get from these kind of surveys.
Okay. So what else is going on with Fort Cavazos Calvary Family Housing?
Well, since we're talking about the springtime, we always know that there's a lot. There are a lot of deploying family members that are out there right now. So we just wanted to reiterate too that we have many programs to take care of the family while their soldier's away, or the family's away from the house for that matter. So we have a strong spouse program that we've got out there.
Okay.
That strong spouse program. When your soldier does deploy, you bring a copy of the deployment orders into the community center, and we will take care of mowing the entire lawn. Because right now, the resident is responsible for mowing their backyard.
Right.
And they bring the orders in, we take care of all the mowing while the soldier is deployed. And we also offer a punch card to the spouse that remains back. Mm-hmm. And that punch card can be used to do small tasks around the house. We'll come in and we'll hang pictures.
Okay.
Do small things around the house that the deployed spouse may have done in the past. So there's a lot of benefit in the Strong Spouse Program. Along with that, we got a home care program as well. The home care program is when the family is outside of the house for more than 30 days. When they're gone for more than 30 days, Calvary Family Housing will go by and check on the house to make sure that the house is safe and secure and there's nothing, you know, wrong inside the house as well.
Okay. So I want to just go back. Firstly, how do families and soldiers become involved in or get involved in these two programs?
Absolutely. Well, for the Strong Spouse Program, like I said, once they have deployment orders, they bring the deployment order over to their community center, and the community manager, their community management team, will sign them up for the Strong Spouse Program.
Okay. So the family member can bring the paperwork over in case the soldier's already...
Absolutely.
Okay.
And we find that all the time. The soldier's already in Korea. The soldier's already in Europe. Mm-hmm. And I'll be talking to a spouse, and I'll ask her, have you signed up this program? She didn't know anything about it. And I said, well, she's got the orders. Bring the orders to us, and we'll sign you up for the program.
Yeah, this is a great resource for, you know, parents who have children, and things have gotten a lot busier with a deployed spouse. So this helps out a lot, a great deal.
Absolutely. And for the home care program, if you're going to be gone longer than 30 days, just stop by and see your community manager. they'll add it to a list and we'll keep an eye on the house.
Okay. So I remember covering an event this past holiday season with the teddy bears. So you guys touch, you know, the soldiers and the families in so many ways, much more than just providing equipment and supplies. So the manager at Lawn and Garden, LaDina Pikert, her mother-in-law actually created a bunch of handmade, hand-stitched teddy bears that she gives out on the installation and to, you know, throughout the community to different hospitals. So, you know, those little acts of kindness, you know, they go a long way. So how do you feel about that?
Absolutely. Is this another fine touch that we have on the customer experience here in Fort Cavazos? And we take pride on that. And like I said, if you just stop by the Lawn and Garden and just talk to them over there, I mean, they're a wealth of information about what's going on Fort Cavazos. They talk about, a lot of them are retired, they're veterans. They talk about their Army experiences. And those small touches, though, again, I think set us apart from living off post.
Absolutely.
And that's how we look at it. And that's, you know, very evident, like I said, in some of these survey questions that are coming back and some of the feedback we're getting from these surveys is, I think residents do appreciate that. They know it's different than living off post. It's a different experience, and it's a very positive experience. At the end of the day, it comes down to people. And our people value our residents. They care for our residents. I see it all the time. And I think that care comes through. Like I said, it comes through in these surveys. It comes through in different, you know, responses of feedback we get. And these small touches like the teddy bears that LaDina, you know, her mother-in-law made, are just one example of going above and beyond for that customer experience, that positive customer experience.
Absolutely. So while we're touching on the survey, how do families and soldiers get access to that?
So they should have gotten it in the in their email.
Okay.
And that email that's on file with the community center was where the Army sent the survey. It's coming from a contractor, CEL. Mm-hmm. So it should be from the CEL. It should be CEL in email. And if they have not received the survey, they can contact their community management team, and the community management team will help them work with CEL in order to get the survey sent to them.
Okay. You mentioned that Fort Cavazos Calvary Family Housing has a scholarship. Tell us a little bit more about that.
Yeah, so this is another perk of living on post. My company, Lendlease, every year they push out the Blue Star Scholarship Program, where scholarships for our on post residents are awarded up to $5,000 for, you know, a kid that's going to college next year or a spouse that's, you know, going to a technical school. So That's out there, too, and they're accepting applications until the 27th of May.
Okay.
All that information can be found at the community center, or they can find it on our Facebook page. But we're really hoping to get a good response from our residents. And, again, a $5,000 scholarship only offered to residents, another great benefit that, you know, sets us apart from living off post.
Absolutely. So you said they can get more information, or they can apply on the Calvary Family Housing Facebook page?
They can find the application
on
Calvary Family Housing Facebook page. But they can also get a hold of their community manager, and their community manager can get them the information and the application as well.
Okay. Is there a phone number they can call if they want more information?
Yeah, there is a phone number on the webpage, on the Facebook page, 615-963-2770, or they can email bluestar1word@lendlease.com.
So before we go, you know, I would be remiss if I didn't ask about how to beautify your lawn, you know, what it takes. So you guys gave away free mulch, free, sod, and free grass seed. So I can attest to a lawn that needs help. So what are the, you know, tips, techniques you have for getting a lush green lawn?
Well, with the grass seed we have the grass seed called Fresque. And you have spots in your grass. With that Fresque, you just add the water, put water down first, and then add the seed, and it will take in about 3 days. So,
oh, wow.
Clean up the spots, that the dead spots they have. And the mulch, if you want to beautify your tree, or anything like that, and the dirt for the dogs that dig holes or whatever.
Right.
You know, like if they're not, if they got too much shade, what kind of grass, when the water, or anything like that.
That's but my that's issue. I have two very large trees in my front yard, and there is a patch where there's like no grass. It's just kind of dirt. So what would you suggest?
More water.
So grass seed and more water.
Yes. When you got shade, a little bit more water because the tree would take all the water.
Right. And I'm nutrients. Starting to understand that is why no grass is growing there.
Put some nutrients down there, you know, formaldehyde or anything like that, weed and feed, because the tree gone suck up everything. So it'll save a little for the grass so you get some green spots back.
Okay, so you guys heard it here. Fort Cavazos Calvary Family Housing has got plenty of resources and services to help you maintain your home, make things easier for you, provide you with all the things you need to keep your lawn beautiful. And if it's not beautiful now, you can work on it for this upcoming spring season. Well, you guys have given us a plethora of information, and we are so, so grateful for you coming on today and letting us know about the great things that Calvary Family Housing does here at The Great Place. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Janice.
Thank you.
Just a few on Friday night, out with friends, tailgating a game on Sunday, a couple after a rough day, off work early, late call tomorrow. It's easy to let the excuses add up and lose your grip on things. Alcohol abuse is a complicated issue and often starts with casual social drinking. The Army Substance Abuse Program can help you develop healthy habits and coping skills to navigate the ups and downs of military life. Don't let excessive drinking ruin your career. Talk to ASAP before it's too late.
Hey everyone, this is Eric Franklin, and Janice, I am mad that I didn't get to get any tips about keeping my lawn and garden. I know it's only for those people who are on the insulation, but I'm still mad I didn't get a couple of tips.
Well, yeah, they did give a few tips. You know, the biggest tip was to water, water, water. And with the summer coming up, and I'm anticipating really hot temperatures, I don't know how feasible that's going to be, especially if we have, you know, more restrictions on watering like we did this past season, so...
Yeah, I think for me, I like to water in the evening anyway. So that's the best advice that I've ever got was just always water my grass in the evening.
Right.
Yeah, so that's the best thing that I got.
But we talked a lot about what the Lawn and Garden program does and what the resources they provide. Basically, they have all the little odds and ends that make it easier for residents to take care of small tasks at home, like, you know, light bulbs, door stops, shower heads, blinds, things like that. And also being able to rent out equipment like lawnmowers, leaf blowers, trimmers and hedgers, like things like that to help keep the landscaping looking great. You know, a lot of people... PCS very often, and they don't, you know, want to purchase those things and then have to carry them and have nowhere to put them. So it's easy to be able to rent it.
Yeah. And speaking of Calvary Family Housing, did you know that the Army has a survey available for everyone who lives in Army Family Housing across all the installations? That survey goes from now until April 18th. That feedback is important for both the Army and those families who are living in Calvary Family Housing. It helps improve the residents' experience as these results are used to develop action plans for improvements to the installations, communities, and some of the past recommendations have led to changes to renovation design plans and how the change occupancy maintenance. Basically, what that survey is going to do, it's going to tell the big Army how they're doing, how families are doing here at Calvary Family Housing and across the installation. And you can do all that by sending an email, confidential email. No one's going to know. Your unit commander, no, your next one, everyone won't know, to armyhousingsurvey@CELASSOCIATES.com. For additional questions and information, you can contact Fort Cavazos Housing at area code 254-287-4212. And if you pick up this week's paper, there's a QR code in there that you can check it out as well.
Yes. I just want to reiterate how important that survey is. You, your opinions and your ideas, they matter, but no one is going to know unless you let us know. So this is a great platform for you to exercise to get your voices heard.
Yes, it is. And you can't, you that way, you know, if you want to see a monument in the middle of housing, that's the only way you're going to get it there is if you have to have to do that survey and you have to voice your concerns.
Absolutely. And speaking of family things, so registration for youth sports is open until March 22nd. I love youth sports.
I do too.
Yeah. So the Fort Cavazos Directorate of Family and Morale, Welfare and Recreation's Youth Sports and Fitness, they have a run club. They have tennis and golf available for the spring sports season. So any one of those. Registration for these sports is open until March 22nd, as I stated before. For more information on what ages can participate, the cost, and the season dates, visit cavazos.armymwr.com.
And staying with our friends over at the Cavazos Army MWR, did you know that they have a thing called Bounce Into Money Bingo?
I did not.
Yes. So for those who didn't know, Fort Cavazos Directorate of Family Morale and Welfare and Recreation is hosting a bunny bingo and movie event at 7 p.m. March 23rd at the Belton Lake Outdoor Recreation Area, also known as Ballora. It's called the Live Oak Pavilion out there. Gates open up at 6:30 and gate entry is $10 per vehicle. So everyone, if you don't know, that means if you have a Winnebago, you can put as many people as you can get into that Winnebago and you only have to pay $10.
$10.
It also includes, with that $10, each person in that card would get a free bingo card for each guest. Extra cards can be purchased, $5 each. Food and beverages and snow cones are available for purchase. For more information, visit cavazos.armymwr.com.
Oh, my goodness. Bingo and snacks?
And a movie.
Oh, bingo, snacks, and a movie. Exactly. Okay, I love it even more. And, you know, I'm a competitive person. And in the spirit of competition, we have the Ben Hogan Classic registration coming up soon. So active duty soldiers can register for the Ben Hogan Classic at 11 a.m. on March 28th at the course of Clear Creek until all spots are filled. So don't procrastinate. I know I do it a lot, so you may not want to do it this time.
And, and for those, real quick, and for those of our listeners who are planning on getting up there, it says 11 a.m. is when sign up starts. I would recommend getting up there at 09 because that line usually, they usually fill up within 30 minutes. The past 3 years, they have filled up all their spots for all their teams within 30 minutes. So if you want to get there, make sure you get there extra early because it says 11 a.m. But it's not like, oh, I'm going to get there 11:10. You're probably not going to get a spot.
Okay, so yeah. According to Eric, you might want to get there a couple of hours earlier.
If you don't believe me, ask someone who's been there before. So I'm just saying.
Well, this golf scramble is conducted in three-person teams. The golf scramble will be played on April 26th.
Speaking of newcomers, every week there's a newcomers orientation brief. That installation orientation is a way for soldiers and their family members to learn about everything that is available here on The Great Place. The event happens every Thursday at 9 a.m. at the Lone Star Conference Center. Doors open at 8:45 and it starts promptly at 9. Now, for those who may have those family members and those soldiers who may come out and they have little ones, there is free on-site childcare that is available for you. To call or to get more information or sign up for that childcare, all you have to do is call 254-287-0027.
So that newcomers orientation is a great way to get acclimated to The Great Place and find out about all the great resources and services and organizations and programs that are specifically catered towards soldiers and their families. So
yeah, you know, I think it's a good source of information, whether, you know, you've been here one time or this is you're a frequent flyer to The Great Place. I think it is a valuable tool because I think every couple of years something major changes on the installation or the way some processes may work may change. And there may be more stuff that's available than the last time you were here. So
right.
I think it's a very good thing that here we have here at
Absolutely, because things change often.
Yeah.
So you want to, it's a great way to stay updated. on those changes.
And you get to, you know, after you have the brief, you walk through and you get to see all those agencies that are on the installation as well as off the installation.
Absolutely.
And you get to see them. And if you're new to the installation, make sure you stop by the public affairs table and pick up a newspaper.
Absolutely. So you guys can stay up to date and aware on all the newsworthy happenings at Fort Cavazos and within the Central Texas community.
Yeah.
So what do you got going on this weekend, Eric?
Well, I'm glad that you mentioned that. I am going out of town for a couple of weeks.
Nice.
More like, I don't know how many weeks there are in 90 days that I'm going to be gone.
That is approximately 12 weeks.
12 weeks. See, I didn't know that. So, but I will be gone for 12 weeks, guys, so you won't get to hear my loud, overbearing voice. I will be thinking about you guys. I'll have to see. I may do a call-in. If something really cool happens where I'm at,
that would be awesome. We would love that.
So we'll see. But other than that, I just have a little bit of housekeeping stuff to do. I got to cut my grass one more time before I get out of here.
And according to Lawn and Garden, get some seed. Feed that grass.
Yeah. So that's the big thing too. I'm going to overseed my yard. I should have done it already, but I'm still going to do it. It'll still work.
Well, they say this is a great time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not too hot and it's not too cold. So we'll see.
Well, you know, being that we just spoke to them and I got plenty of pointers, that is my goal for this weekend, is to kind of get the lawn prepared so that I can actually grow it out.
Yeah. Is that the only plans you have for this weekend?
Yeah, I don't have too much going on. It's not one of my get to go out of town weekends, unfortunately. But it's okay. I love being at home and taking care of home stuff. It's great for me.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. All right. Well, that's it, I guess. And again, we thank you guys for tuning in. Make sure you like and share. And I think that's all we have.
I guess since there's no more football, I guess I will now be tuning in to March Madness. So yeah. I may take in some games this weekend as well.
Yeah, I'll watch it. It'll be on in the background.
Right.
All right. Thank you, guys. And we'll talk to you next time. Bye.
Bye.
This podcast is a U.S. Army Garrison Fort Cavazos and Fort Cavazos Public Affairs production. Have a question or want to share some of your wisdom with us? Drop us an email at fortcavazos@gmail.com. You can follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at Fort Cavazos Army. And as always, be sure to leave us a review